running with 2 G's. What's up, YouTube? Reggie here. I wanted to broach the topic of too much power. This stems, well, I'm not even gonna tell you where the origins come from. I just popped in my head, but I was on YouTube watching a bunch of videos of a guy with a bunch of different motorcycles, guys with supercharge or turbocharge or whatever with their magic. I don't know how that stuff works. To a motorcycle engine, and they were outputting like crazy amounts of horsepower. You know, I think it was like a FZ09 that was putting out like almost 200 horsepower from the dyno. You know, and I know that's crazy, and I know dynos can be off, but that's insane. And I think I watched a video with a guy in an FZ08. Every gear from first to sixth, he would power wheelie. Every gear, the front end would come up. And it got me thinking, I'm like, is there such a thing as too much power in a motorcycle? I mean, these like 1,000 cc's, almost said 1,000 cc supermotos. It's 1,000, that would be a crazy big 1,000 cc. I want to see a 1,000 cc supermoto. Someone make me a 1,000 cc supermoto. These 1,000 cc super sport bikes or super bikes are getting to the point where they're getting close to that. And I remember an interview when they released the new R1, and all this could be construed as, you know, Yamaha trying to make themselves look cool. But an interview with Valentino Rossi, who drives their prototype bike in racing, he said that the bikes now are to the point where you have to have the electronics to ride them. It'd be impossible for you to ride, you know, the new R1 without the electronics. I always see those two bikes around this time. And that got me thinking, I'm like, man, is there such thing as too much power? I mean, I love my bike, and when I first got on it, going from 34 horsepower to however much this had and the torque, I was blown away, and I've kind of gotten used to it. You know, but I'm like, do I really want more power? Is that what we really want? Because I think I would be terrified if I would rip this bike in first gear and it would power wheelie. That'd be kind of terrifying. And then imagine ripping through all the gears, knowing that you can't even crack the throttle, you know, quarter way open, because if you crack it any further, because there's just gobs and gobs of power, the front end gonna come up. I mean, and it becomes a point where I think there's a such thing as too much power. You know, even for the road, even on the track. You know, I've never ridden on the track, but I, you know, it's like, I would think, this is what I think. I think at a certain point, you get to the point where a nice R6, where you have so much power that you're fighting the bike more so. I mean, in MotoGP, I mean, they're, you know, their bikes do 250 horsepower. And it's been said that, that a lot of the tracks of them feel like go-kart tracks because they go so fast. You know, and then they have all those electronics. If any of the electronics fail, boom, done. So, but that's for racing, and I get that with racing, but on the road, do we really need bikes that can produce, you know, 200 horsepower plus on the road? I don't think so. Maybe it's just my age speaking. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. Leave a comment down below, skis. If you like what you see, hit subscribe. Hit the like, share this video. And anyone, you know, who views, comments, subscribes, likes this video, thank you. Thank you. All right, I will catch you guys later.